Welcome back, students, to my new lecture on transport of fish. Fish transportation plays an important role in the distribution of quality fish and also fish fry among a country or even the world. And fishes are transported mainly for different purposes, such as breeding purposes, such as stocking purposes, such as selling purposes. Now, during transport, mass mortality occurs, and the mortality of the fish, which may be expected during transportation, is mainly due to the depletion of dissolved oxygen and accumulation of the gases like ammonia and carbon dioxide in the water carriers. And these gases are lethal as they may reduce the oxygen carrying capacity of fish blood. As for example, if the concentration of dissolved free ammonia exceeds 2 ppm, what is ppm? 1 mg per 1000 ml concentration, that is a ppm, the seed fish may die. However, the lethal limits owing to carbon dioxide in fish depend on the level of dissolved oxygen. Now, generally, what are the causes for mortality during the transportation? Oxygen depletion, accumulation of free carbon dioxide resulting from respiration, and ammonia as excretory product, sudden fluctuation in temperature, hyperactivity and stress due to handling, ion osmotic imbalance due to stress, physical injury due to handling, and diseases. Now, in the traditional fish transport system, generally, earthen pots are used. Now, several drawbacks during the transportation of fish by these earthen pots. The methods generally that commonly applied in that procedure, the earthen pots are likely to break in a transit, may be injured owing to the shaking of pots, possibly only for short distances and short duration. Frequently, changes of water may result in the mortality of the fish, owing to difference in the water quality. এখানে আর্দেন পটস গুলোকে দেখানো হয়েছে আর্দেন পটে যদি মাছগুলোকে আমরা একটা জায়গা থেকে আরেকটা জায়গায় নিয়ে যাই যখন আমরা ভেহিকলসে যাব রাস্তা খারাপ থাকলে সেগুলো সংঘর্ষের ফলে সেগুলো ভেঙে যেতে পারে এর ফলে মাছের যে কোনো পোরশন ইনজিওর্ড হয়ে যেতে পারে সিমিলারলি দিস ইজ অলসো দ্য ট্র্যাডিশনাল সিস্টেম এখানে একটা টলি টলি চারদিকে টিপল দিয়ে ঘিরে এখানে জল ভর্তি করে এখানে বিভিন্ন ধরনের মাছ বেসিক্যালি ডিমপোনা মাছ একটা পুকুর থেকে একটা পুকুরে ট্র্যাডিশনাল সিস্টেমে নিয়ে যাওয়া হয় এবং এটা একদম এজ ওল্ড প্র্যাকটিস জেনারেলি বাঁকে করে হাঁড়ি রয়েছে হাঁড়ির ভেতর যে মাছ সেই মাছ একটা জায়গা থেকে একটা জায়গায় স্থানান্তরিত করা হয় এবং এটা গ্রামের দিকে এখনো অনেক পোর সেক্টর যে পিপল এইভাবে তারা জীবিকা অর্জন করে থাকে নাও Nowadays, modern methods are introduced. And that is a closed systems. Here, the fishes are generally transported in the containers, such as different types of pots nowadays available that are made by metal, wooden, metal bucket, vats, barrels, plastic bags, styrofoam boxes. This is actually the styrofoam boxes, bottles, jugs, animal skins, and bamboo section. In fact, almost any clean waterproof container may be used. Certain containers provide good insulation from heat, as per example, wood or styrofoam that are present here. And the containers like metal or plastics are poor insulators and may have to wrap with wet towels or packed with ice to keep the temperature down. Now, basically, there are two methods for the transportation of the fish. One is the open system and another is a closed systems. Open systems, that is a water-filled container. And in these containers, the requirements for the survivals that are maintained by outside resources, by the outside resources, that is the open system. Whereas in case of the closed system, it is a sealed container in which all the requirements for survival are self-contents. Open system ki ekhane mukto royeche ekhane er ja jabotiyo dorkar seigulo baire theke supply kora hoy. That is open system. What is a closed system? Closed system, that's mean it is sealed packed. Ja jabotiyo jinish ekhane rekhe etake pack kore deya hoyeche. That's mean baire theke ar kintu kono sar kora jabe na. That is a closed system. Now, the open system is a traditional method. that consists of water filled container in which the requirements for survival are supplied continuously from the outside sources. And that comprises an open carrier that needs artificial aeration or without artificial aerations, plastics or metal drums or traditionally earthen pots that are known as a hundi that are used for fish transporting, and dissolved oxygen content is maintained through splashing of water during the movements. Now, what are the advantages of the open system? It is a cheap and easier methods. No equipments, generally no equipments are used in that particular system. Keep water cool for long time. No need to oxygen supply from outsides, more suitable for brute fish transportation. Now, what are the drawbacks of the open systems? Relatively less amount of the fish can be transported at a time due to depletions of oxygens. Now, needs close observation, not suitable for larger distance. Jodi onek gulo mach amra onek durutte niye jete chai, tahole kintu open system e niye jete parbo na. Now, what is a closed system? The closed system is a sealed container, and all the requirements for survival are self-contained. The simplest closed system is a sealed plastic bag, partially filled with water and oxygen, and it is a modern transport system. Adequate oxygen supply is maintained in the water while transporting the fish. Different types of nowadays containers come: metal, wooden, metal bucket, bats, barrel, plastic bags, styrofoam boxes, bottles, jars, animal skins, etc., etc. Nowadays available that are used for the transporting of the fish. Now, this container, one fourth of the container that's contain water and the fish, and the rest of the bags is filled with oxygen. After adding oxygen, the bag is sealed or shutted with a twisted rubber band, and in sometimes some oven glasses or sometimes ice are also used during the packing to provide insulation from heat. Now, what are the advantages of the closed system? Oxygen can be supplied easily. Mortality risk is very low. That is important. So that is suitable for commercial fish farm. Easily transportable. Fishes can be transported for a long distance, even from a country to another country. And large number of the fishes can be transported at a time. And what are the drawbacks of this system? It is a cost-effective method. Packing materials are not locally available and need skilled worker for packing and handling. And additional oxygen is required. Now, what are the considerations needs for the transport of the fish? Fish transport must be done carefully in order to be successful. And any kinds of mistakes, any kinds of error that can damage the total procedures and ultimately the fish die. So the following factors direct influence the fish transport: tolerance to transport, presence of food in the intestine, age and size of the fish, and the climatic conditions. That are the considerations. So first one, একটা খুব সুন্দর লাইন আছে যে মাছ কিন্তু আলু নয়, যে আলুর বস্তার মধ্যে যেমন আলু আমরা ভরি, হেপাজাটলি ভরে আমি ট্র্যাক্টরে ঠেলে ফেলে দিলাম, আলুর বস্তাটা নিয়ে চলে যাব, এরকম করলে কিন্তু হবে না। ফিশেস আর নট দ্য পটেটোস, দে নিড টেন্ডার কেয়ার অ্যান্ড লাভ টু রিমেইন স্ট্রং অ্যান্ড হেলদি, অ্যান্ড দ্য এবিলিটি টু রেজিস্ট অর অ্যাডেপ্ট টু স্ট্রেসফুল কন্ডিশন। সব মাছের কিন্তু সব ক্ষমতা নেই ট্রান্সপোর্টের এই যে ধকলটা নিতে পারার জন্য। কিছু কিছু মাছ আছে যাদের অ্যাক্সেসরি রেসপিরেটরি অর্গানস আছে, দ্যাটস হ্যাভ এ মোর টলারেন্স টু ট্রান্সপোর্ট, such as oreochromis and different types of the catfish, and some fishes that the medium tolerance to species, such as the carps, Indian carps, generally different types of puntias species also, and the low tolerance species, that is the silver carps. So that are the category. So the tolerance varies from species to species. Now, presence of the food in the intestine, fish survive ট্রান্সপোর্ট বেটার ইফ দে হ্যাভ নো ফুড ইন দেয়ার ইন্টেস্টিন। যে মাছগুলোকে আমরা ট্রান্সপোর্ট করব, এক থেকে দুদিন আগে তাদেরকে কিছু খাওয়ানো যাবে না, দ্যাটস মিন তাদেরকে স্টারভেশন পিরিয়ডে রাখতে হবে, দ্যাটস মিন ইন্টেস্টিনের মধ্যে কোনো ফুড পার্টিকেল থাকবে না, দ্যাটস মিন এক্সক্রিটরি সাবস্টেন্স তাদের ড্রপিং তুলনামূলক কম হবে, ড্রপিং হবে না বললেই চলে। এবং মাছেদের তো রিকোয়ারমেন্ট থাকবেই সবসময় অক্সিজেন তাদের সার্ভাইভালের জন্য, কিন্তু যে ড্রপিংসগুলো সেগুলো যদি জলে পড়ে তাহলেও তাদের আবার অক্সিজেন দরকার থাকবে। এর ফলে যে যে পরিমাণ অক্সিজেনটা সাফিসিয়েন্ট ছিল সেই পরিমাণটা আস্তে আস্তে কমবে। সো জেনারেলি ফিশ ক্যান অলসো বি হারভেস্টেড অ্যান্ড হেল্ড ইন নেট এনক্লোজার টু ট্যাঙ্কস 24 to 48 hours উইথ ক্লিন প্রিফারেবলি জেন্টল রানিং ওয়াটার। যে মাছগুলোকে ট্রান্সপোর্ট করব সেই মাছগুলোকে ধরে নেটের মধ্যে ক্লোজ অবজারভেশনে রাখা হয়, এবং ক্লোজ অবজারভেশনে রাখা হয় তার গুড কন্ডিশনটা দেখার জন্য। এবং সিমিলারলি সেই মাছগুলোকে আমরা ইজিলি আমরা সিলেক্ট করে আমরা ট্রান্সপোর্ট যে ভেহিকেল সে ভেহিকেলসে নিয়ে যেতে পারবো। এতে কি আমাদের যে ওয়েস্টেজ অফ দ্য টাইম সেটাও কম হয় অনেকটা। নাও এজ অ্যান্ড দ্য সাইজ অফ দ্য ফিশ, এ লোয়ার ওয়েট অফ দ্য ফিশ দ্যাট ইজ এ স্মল ফিশ দ্যাট ক্যান বি ট্রান্সপোর্টেড পার ইউনিট ভলিউম অফ ওয়াটার দেন লার্জার ফিশ দ্যাট গাইডস ক্লাসিফাই দ্য ফিশ বডি ইন্টু ফোর মেইন গ্রুপস অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দেয়ার লাইফ সাইকেল স্টেজ। নিউলি হ্যাচড ফিশেস দ্যাট আর নোন অ্যাজ এ স্যাক ফ্রাই আর স্লো মুভিং অ্যান্ড দে পজেসেস ইয়র স্যাক হুইচ প্রোভাইডস দেম at least 24 hour food supply after hatching. In that period, the hatchling don't require any type of the food. They consume the foods that are stored in their yolk sacs. Now the post larvae do not have the yolk sacs and they are commonly called the chicken fry. The weight less than 1 gram, the digestive system developed, the pooled developed, no enzyme secretion, not in this particular stage. And then 3 to 4 week old fish that's weighing more than 1 gram, that is a fingerling, and the sexually mature fish that is a broodstock. And these are the different size of the fish mentioned here, newly hatched, then 1 4 inch, 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, and in case of the newly hatched, 1 hour duration 120 specimens, in case of 12 hour 80 specimens, in case of 20 hour 40 specimens, and in case of 48 hour 10 specimens. Whereas in case of 3 inch, that is a 1 hour for 120, 12 hour for 105, 24 hour for 90 specimen, 48 for 40 species. So this is a table that show the fish size and what are the durations for their transport. Now the numbers, that is a rough guidelines, and that may not work under all conditions or for all kinds of the fish. And there is another factor, climatic condition. Generally, fishes are transported during the coolest part of the day. It may be early morning, it may be nights where the temperature is very low. That is important factors. Now, what are the factors and what are the principles that are associated with a fish transport? The factors are quality of the fish, oxygen, and different types of water parameters, temperature, density, and biochemical changes and stresses in the transported fish. So first one is the quality of the fish. The quality of the fish transported, that is the main criteria. The fish that is to be transported must be healthy and in good condition. Weak specimens should be eliminated from the shipping, particularly when the temperature during shipment is high. Weak fish dies at higher rate than fish in good condition when the transport time is longer. That is important. Now the second one, oxygen. The most important single factor in transporting fish, that is providing the adequate level of the dissolved oxygen. However, an abundance of oxygen within a tank does not necessarily indicate that the fish are in good conditions. The ability of the fish to use oxygen depends on their tolerance to stress, water temperature, pH, and concentration of carbon dioxide and metabolic products such as ammonia. Larger fish and those transported in the warmer water need more oxygen. For instance, if the water temperature increases by 10 degrees centigrade, oxygen consumption is about doubled. Oxygen defect may occur when the density of the fish is too high or the transport is longer than the fish can stand. The dead fish compete with living ones for oxygen, increase bacterial multiplication, requiring much oxygen, and produce toxic metabolites. Now, the slime produced by the fish, that is another substrate for the bacterial growth, resulting in a decrease of oxygen content in the water. This process is intensified when the water temperature is higher. Now, different water parameters. Water quality is a function of the load of the fish, concentration, and the length of the time for which the fish are transported. The source of the water that is used during transport must have been tested before dispatching a mass consignment of the fish. such as pH, carbon dioxide, chlorine, and ammonia, that are the vital parameters during the transport of the fish. The water pH level is a control factor because the proportions of toxic ammonia and carbon dioxide content are direct function of the pH. With increasing transport time, carbon dioxide production through fish respiration shifts water pH towards acidity, and water pH levels about 7 to 8 that are considered as optimum, and rapid changes in the pH, but stress occurs on the fish body, but supports can be used to stabilize the water pH during the transport. The organic soluble buffer, generally TRIS buffer, TRIS hydroxymethyl aminomethane, that is a quite effective 1.3 to 2.6 gram per liter commonly used, and fish transported in the tanks are exposed to gradually increasing the concentration of the carbon dioxide. Aerations of the water that will reduce the concentration of the dissolved carbon dioxide. And another factor, chlorine. Generally, chlorine are present in the municipal water and the tap water, and that is removed from the water by the aerations. And generally, 0.5 milligram per liter chlorine, that is considered as a dangerous level. And the another one, ammonia, that's builds up in the transport water due to protein metabolism of the fish and bacterial action on the wasp. Now, decreasing metabolic rate of the fish by lowering the water temperature and thus diminish fish activity reduces the production of the ammonia. Now, the production of the ammonia by bacterial action can be decreased by sipping fish only after the food has been withheld long enough to void the stomach and intestine. We have already mentioned at the prior to transport, 2 to 4 days before, no foods are generally put to the water bodies. And all of you know that is a consideration of check factors. If more food given to the water bodies, then they consume more and more. So large number of the food particles present in the intestine. So the droppings occurs in the medium, and that needs a much oxygen. So oxygen deficiency occurs, and another that's a ammonia that's builds up in the transport water. So that's a hazardous. Now the temperature. Water temperature is an important factor. When water temperature is low, the pH remains higher and fish metabolism decreases. A need for adapting the fish to a lower water temperature may also arise before transport. And generally natural ice is used to the water at the rate of 25 kg of ice that will cool 1000 liter of the water by 2 degrees centigrade. And water temperature ranging 18 to 28 degrees centigrade, that is suitable for transporting warm water fish, and the ideal temperature is 21 to 25 degrees centigrade. Now the density, the ratio of the volume of the fish transported and the transport water, that should not exceed 1:3 for heavier specimen, but with smaller specimen, the ratio decreases 1:100 to 200. And the stock density of the fish that is in the container also depends on the length of the transport. Also depends on the length of the transport. If the container contain so many specimens, the duration will be small. If the container contain small amount of the specimens, we can carry the specimens for larger distance. And the stock density of the fish container, that's also dependence on the length of the transport. The pattern of this dependence characterized by the hyperbolic curve. That is a hyperbolic curve. And this is a short trip, a large number of the specimens present in a container. And this is a long trips, the same container that contains small amount of the species. Now, what are the biochemical changes and the stresses that occurs in the transporting phase? Shipment condition that influences the composition of the blood and the parameters of the blood serum biochemistry. When the fish are transported at higher densities, the level of the corticoids and the glucose in the plasma that increases and retains when the transport is finished. And it should also be noted that release of the fish at that destination can be the most critical stage of the transport process. That's when the fishes are now in the closed conditions. When the fishes are released in the new water body, that creates a problems because they are not adapted, so many differences, water parameter differences, temperature differences, so the fish under some degree of the stress in the transport unit and sudden exposure to the water of the different characteristics or low quality will further the stress of fish and often beyond when they cannot stand. And poor quality water may mean freshly pumped groundwater with low oxygen or high carbon dioxide content. Different characteristics of water often mean a pH, temperature, or gas saturation difference between the transport unit and also the receiving water. Now, what is the methods for the transporting of the fish? Maintain adequate oxygen in the water. That is a single factor during the transporting of the fish. Maybe bubbled continuously into an unsealed container during transport or injected in the plastic bags that's containing water and the fish, which is then sealed in the airtight conditions for the transports. And 1/4 of the bag that usually contains water and the fish, and the 3/4 part that contains the oxygen. After adding oxygen, the bag is sealed. The bag is sealed and sewed with a twisted rubber band, string, or other material. As a precaution against leakage, the first plastic bag again put into the another second bag whenever possible. Now the sealed double bag of the fish is then packed in a box, open grass bags, or other container for adapted protections and loaded onto a vehicle for the transport. And if properly packaged and insulated for heat, these containers can be transported for 24 to 48 hours without water exchange. That is important. Now, what are the chemicals that's needed to the water during the transportation of the fish? Now, So the chemical methods of the treating the transport medium aimed at increasing the capacity, volume of the transport units, and preventing physiological and health damage to the fish constitute an integral part of the complex problem of the fish transports. What are the tranquilizers, application of the sodium chlorides and calcium chlorides, bacteriostatic chemicals, buffers, ammonia control, and some antifoam chemicals? So first one, tranquilizer during transport. Sedation of the fish is desirable since oxygen consumption and carbon dioxide and ammonia productions are all decreased. Anesthesia usually applies only to transport the brood fish, Trichin, methyl sulfonate, and quinidine, that is used for most frequently, MST2, that is a trade name of the trichin methyl sulfonate. The dose is at the rate of 10 to 35 milligram per liter. And that is a very mild anesthetic agent. And another anesthetic agent, quinidine, that is a 2,4 methyl quinoline at the rate of 15 to 30 mg per liter. That is a high toxic liquid. So must therefore be handled with care. The fish are usually treated with when it they are held in a large volume of the water. So the অনেকগুলো মাছ নিয়ে যাই, অনেক বড় ক্যাপাসিটি থাকে কন্টেনার, তখন ইউজ করব কুইনালডিন, এন্ড ইট ইজ আ হাইলি টক্সিক। আর যদি অল্প মাছ থাকে, অল্প জল থাকে, তখন আমরা ইউজ করব MST2, দ্যাট ইজ আ ডোজ ইজ 10 টু 35 মিলিগ্রাম পার লিটার, হোয়ারাস ইন কেস অফ দ্য কুইনালডিন দ্য ডোজ ইজ 15 টু 30 এমজি পার লিটার। কিন্তু ওয়াটার কন্টেনারটাকে বড় হতে হবে, লার্জার ভলিউম অফ ওয়াটারের ক্ষেত্রে ইউজ করব। নাও next one is the application of the sodium chloride and the calcium chloride. Handling stress and delayed mortality of the fish can be decreased by the adding of the sodium chloride and also calcium chloride to the transport water. The sodium ion tends to harden the fish and reduce slime formation, and the calcium ion suppresses osmoregularity and metabolic dysfunction. Calcium chloride may not be needed in hard water. Hard water means that water contains a high amount of mineral that's containing high concentration of the calcium already. And as per a scientist Hanna, 1984, recommended the addition of 0.1 to 0.3% sodium chloride and 50 milligram per liter calcium chloride required during the transportation of the fish. Now, bacteriostatic chemicals. Antibacterials are used to check the development of the bacteria in the transport units, and wide spectrum of the bacteriostatic drugs nowadays used, such as fluorescence at the rate of 10 mg per liter, acriflavin 1 to 2 mg per liter, and terramycin 20 mg per liter. So this is the structure of the fluorescence, and this is the structure of the acriflavin. Now the buffers, generally trace buffers, so trace, hydroxyl, methyl, amino, methane, that is helpful in controlling pH at favorable value, that is 7 to 8. The accumulation of the carbon dioxide in the bag transport allows for a degree in pH because carbon dioxide is an that increase the acidity and generally as per scientist Johnson 1979 and Amend et al 4.4 gram per liter generally used whereas Dupree and the Hunter that recommended doses 1.1 to 2.2 gram per liters that are required to control the pH in the bags with only moderate loads. And use of trace buffer in the tank transport, that's usually is impractical because they have a cost. So generally it is not used during the transport of the fish. Now the ammonia control, that is a vital to control ammonia concentration in the transport bags when the transport is expected to be long. Jokhon onek dure jabo, onekta shomoy lagbe, tokhon ammonia ke control korar proyojon hoy. And it is recommended to use a zeolite mineral. And the zeolite mineral that is generally used by Amend et al. 1982, the dose is 14 gram, that's a clino. That is a zeolite mineral that is generally used. Now another is anti-foam chemicals. The formation of foam and scum, especially when the drugs are used in transporting fish or on water, which is heavily laden with organic material by secretion, by excretion, such as mucus, such as excrements, etc., etc., often becomes quite bothers. So the foam interferes with oxygen exposure at the water surface and makes it difficult to observe the fish being carried. In some cases, 10% solution of Dow Corning anti-foam emulsions that is used at the rate of 0.05 ml per liter of the water. And the advantage of the using anti-foam chemicals are not so great, but the use does keep the water more clear, so the fish can observe better. Now, transport of the beaders. Now the beaders have to be transported without soaking and injuring. This may be done using canvas carrier 1 into 1.25 meter or in splashless closed and foam line containers with compressed air. It is always better to give deep baths to the breeders, any kinds of the antiseptics. It may be methylene blue, maybe copper sulfate, maybe potassium permanganate, maybe sodium chlorides. And before transports, the breeders have to be tranquilized using any of the following anesthetics. It may be phenoxyethanol, it may be tarsariamyl alcohol, it may be sodium amytal, MS222, and quinidine also. Now, what are the safety measures during travels? So first one, plan for transporting fish. Most of the fishes can survive for around 48 hours of travel. But beyond that, risk increases and they will not survive. When you stop for the night, you need to take care of the fish. Once the fish have been placed in the transport container, they are brought to their destination by the quickest possible means. That will provide a relatively smooth and direct route. This may be used by foot, animal cart, bicycle, boat, motorized land vehicles, train, or plane. That's when joto taratari parbo amra pouchhe debo tar destination e. Next, change the water for a few days before moving fish. Some of the water in the aquarium should be changed prior to moving and transporting the aquarium. This helps ensure that the water in the tank is clean. Switch out 20% of the water in the aquarium daily for 5 days prior to transporting the aquarium. Now, number three, avoid feeding for 1 to 2 days before moving the fish. Fish can go around a week without food, so they will be fine during transportation. Do not give food for 24 to 48 hours prior to transporting them. And then wait until the last possible moment to pack the fish. Jemon amra berate jaar onek din age theke amra luggage guchhe rakhi. Seta kintu fish er khetre korle hobe na. Fish are very fragile. Should not pack the fish until you are ready to go and waiting to be transported. Should also plan to unpack your fish as soon as you reach your destination. This would be the first thing you unpack. Now, another, avoid unnecessary travel with your fish. Fish are not pets that are easily transported. should not take them on vacation with you or carry them around in a vehicle for fun purpose. These are very fragile, which means you should only transport them when it is absolutely necessary, like when you are moving. So that are the ensuring factors during the travel. Now, what types of the containers you choose during the transport of the fish? Different types of the bags, different types of containers nowadays available. So first one, place fish in a plastic bags. One way to transport the fish is to put them in the plastic bags, fill the bags a third of the way full with water from the aquarium, then place one fish into each plastic bags. Do not put multiple fish in the same bag. Place a second bag over the first bag so that extra protections done. Use a rubber band to secure the bags so the fish and the water cannot get out. Going to have the fish in bags for longer than an hour. Get some pure oxygen from store to place in the bags with them. Now, another, transport the fish in 5 gallon buckets. A 5 gallon bucket can be, that's an easy way to transport multiple fish in the same container, but a new bucket, and do not use chemicals or debris contaminated buckets. Make sure to cover the buckets with a watertight lids and fill the buckets with water from your tank, overhead tank. Now, put the fish into a container, any kind of the container may be used. Another way to transport the fish, any kind of the container that has a lid. Fill the container with water from the tank, make sure the lid is secure so the fish does not fall out and water does not leak out. This may be good for fish with surf fins or who may get out of a plastic bags. Kichu kichu machir ache fin gulo ki kokhono kokhono plastic bag e thakle spine jeglu royeche seglu diye leakage hoye jete pare seglu shei jonno container e niye jawa tai best. Now the transport the aquarium, if it is small, jodi choto aquarium thake seta ke niye jawa jete pare. Small tanks can be moved with the fish and water in it. If you move the aquarium with water in the fish, make sure to remove all other objects, different types of rocks and different types of substance are used for the decoration purpose. This may come loose and injure the fish. So this should be avoided to reduce the risk for spoilage of fish. And the transport the fish into insulated secure chamber. That's a very good procedures. And here the fish are secured. Place the fish in a bags or small container and then pack them in a secure carrier. Place bubble wrap between the fish and if have an insulated container, consider the transporting the fish for a long distance and for long time, and choose a container in large enough for our fish. No matter which container choose for transport the fish, should enough for swim around it. Large container has enough space with water, has enough oxygen for the fish. Fill the container around a third of the way full, and the rest of the container should be open for oxygen. So here, so many tanks are present here. Here the oxygen units are present, cooling units are present, and this is a modern system. Now, place all plants in the plastic bags. I have already mentioned different types of the decorating items, different types of the plants are also present in the aquarium. So these are the decoration purpose, and this will keep the condition closed when they are in the tank and help keep in the good essential essential factors such as the oxygens and other parameters that are important for transporting the fish from one place to the another place. Now, what are the factors that are important for the fish safe during the traveling? Fill the container with water from the top of the tank. From the top of the tank, place the fish in the water from over a tank, not from the direct tap. Fill the transport container with water from the top of the tank. If water is collected from the bottom, wastes, particles are present, and different types of bacteria, sedimentation that are settled on the bottom, that creates a problem. Now, avoid placing items in the container with fish. Should not add fish favorite rocks, plants into the buckets or the container with them. Any extra items may move around and harm the fish. Now, regulate the temperature. Fish need to stay at the normal water temperature. Any fluctuation in warm temperature that can cause fish to get sick. So try to keep fish water the same temperature of the normal aquarium. The fishes are transported in the part of the vehicles where cooling and heating facility, where cooling and heating facility is available. Insulation may also be used to the transportation container, which help regulate the temperature. Place fish in a dark place. Transporting the fish in a darker state can help keep them from getting too stressful. Fish are active and awake during the day when it is bright outside. At night, they are less active. So place a sheet or rug over the container where they can get light during the day. Avoid feeding during travels. Travel is very stressful for fish. Do not worry about opening bags or containers to feed fish. This also helps reduce the needs for elimination, which can make the water it is traveling in dirty. Now, reintroduce the fish to the tank when you arrive. If the fish are transported in the buckets, pour them and the water directly into the tank. Use a net to move them from the buckets to the tank. And if the fish are in bags, place the bags on the top of the water. Let them float. This helps regulate the temperature. This helps regulate the temperature of the water in the bags. When the temperature of the water in the bags are similar, pour the fish into the tanks. And this is the wrong procedures. If you see the buckets that hold the fish and the persons that throw the fish into the water. So that is an unscientific procedure. That is a scientific procedures. You place the buckets in the water, and when the temperature of the bucket and the temperature of the outside water, that will be same, and then the fishes will be released from the buckets. And if you see what are the stocking procedures, you see here, that's to regulate the temperature of the waters and the bags. The poly bags are placed in the waters, and when the temperature of the water in poly bags and the ponds will be same, then you pour the fish to the water body. And this is a correct procedures to release the fish, and this is an incorrect procedure to release the fish. So what is the summary of these topics during the transportation of the fish? Stop feeding fish 24 to 48 hours prior to transporting them. Prepare all transport containers, oxygen, and other equipments. Harvest fish during the coolest part of the day, very early morning if possible. Quickly, urgently load harvested fish into a transport container. Do not overstock. Use bottle oxygen if possible. Insulate from heat during transport. Transport fish on the fastest, smoothest means of transportation available. Upon arrival at the new home, adjust fish to the new surroundings slowly by slowly, gradually exchanging water to avoid temperature and ionic shocks. And these are the reference books. With the help of these books, I have prepared my lecture. Thank you, everybody.